ICD, in general term, in industry, known more as passive ICD. Why passive? Passive means there's no ability to change the setting downhole.
There are two different categories of passive inflow control devices. Both create a pressure drop to manage the reservoir. The first category utilizes friction to create the pressure drop. However, the second category, which is more widely used, creates a pressure drop via a nozzle or orifice. ICDs are also referred to as density-sensitive devices. Let's have a look at why. In the equation of an ICD, the pressure drop, or dp, is a function of half, cd squared, area squared, and rho, all of which determine the flow rate performance, q squared. Cd stands for drag coefficient. This is a quantity that tells us about the drag or resistance of an object in a fluid environment. Let's say we have an ICD encased in a housing inside a reservoir base pipe. Fluids will have to flow through the housing and the nozzle. This movement creates friction or resistance. If the surface of the housing and ICD were perfectly smooth, the CD value would be equal to 1. But because we are working in the real world, the CD value usually falls between 0.8 and 0.97. The next component is area squared, meaning the area of the nozzle opening, which is calculated by pi diameter squared over 4. As the area component depends on the diameter of the nozzle, ICDs are mainly made of tungsten carbide, one of the hardest materials in the world. This ensures that the nozzle keeps the same dimension over time, despite the high volume of fluids flowing through it. The last function is rho, which signifies fluid density. This is in actuality the only fluctuating component of the equation. Density is measured in kilograms per cubic meter, and it will vary depending on the fluid flowing through the ICD, whether it's water, oil, or gas, the density of which also depends on the reservoir temperature and pressure. The CD and area values, on the other hand, are fixed and predetermined by manufacturers. That is why the ICDs are known as density-sensitive devices, as density is the factor which will dictate the flow rate, or Q squared. The ICD was the first inflow control technology to be invented after the oil and gas industry moved from vertical to horizontal drilling, which is also when the heel-toe effect issue first occurred. The oil was drained too fast in the heel section, leading to early gas or water breakthrough, thereby restricting oil production from the toe section. Well pipes were therefore fitted with ICDs of varying nozzle sizes. The smaller sizes were placed at the heel to increase flow resistance. The larger sizes were placed towards the toe to decrease flow resistance. The purpose being to balance the non-uniform production along the length of the well. Although the ICDs were successful, their weakness became evident once gas entered the production stream. Let's have a look at this graph to exemplify. The x-axis is Q, the flow rate. This is the number that will determine how many barrels per day the well will be producing per production valve. Let's plot from 0 to 170 barrels. The y-axis is dp, the pressure drop, which in reservoir terms can mean pressure drawdown. The drawdown pressure is the force that causes the inflow of fluid into the wellbore. This is measured in psi, or pounds per square inch. Let's plot from 0 to 300 psi. With an oil density of 900 kilograms per meter cubed, the oil performance curve will look like this. This means that if the drawdown pressure is 100 psi, you will produce 55 barrels of oil per day. When water starts breaking through at 1000 kilograms per meter cubed, because the density is higher, the ICD will choke the water slightly more. This results in a water performance curve like this. At the same 100 psi, you can see how you would go from producing 55 barrels of oil per day to 50 barrels of water per day. Gas has a density of 100 kilograms per meter cubed, approximately 10 times lower than that of both water and oil. When it breaks through at 100 psi, then the well will produce 160 barrels of gas per day per production valve. This is the main reason why the industry moved from passive ICDs, which are density sensitive, to autonomous ICDs, which are viscosity sensitive.